The only thing I can think of is I'm so happy to have you
here.
We're so excited to be here. Amongst friends and family, artsy folks, all the coolest people that Seattle has to offer. Good-looking people, too, I can tell. So, a lot of you don't really know what's going on in Art Battle. You just happen to walk into the biggest guest night of Art Battle of the year. I'm going to take a second to explain it, and then we're going to start this competition right away. So, hello. My name is Austin. I'll be your spiritual guide for the night. Or an MC, whatever you prefer to call me. I'll be walking around. Feel free to say hello. The way that this works, this incredible competition of inspiration and invention, is that we have two rounds of eight artists. That's bigger than normal for those of you who have been to previous ones. Well, eight artists in two rounds. You all, from there, you all will pick two artists in each of those rounds to go on to a third round of four. Then you all will pick the winner of that round, who will be the champion of the entire season for the region. It's very exciting.
Hold on just one moment. I can't find that. Let me check my Instagram again. I'm getting concerned.
And other things that
you guys can switch off? Okay. Cool. So the plan is, they're at the beginning, they're
going to number one. Okay. So, you have multiple jobs in this community building in your place. Your first job is going to be
Not too quick, though. We don't want to make people dizzy.
Right.
So you're still going to want to do a slow transition.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, if we just do that and jerk it, it's very... I mean, but it's not very pleasant. I mean, if you can do it where it looks good, then... Yeah, just, in my opinion, in a slow pan is, 2 seconds. It's not, not, 5. Yeah. But, okay. Something happens. Can you stand up, do coyote, and then slow down or speed up for walking? Okay, I'm going too fast, and she needs to slow down. Just kind of get my attention and do that, and I'll slow down. Okay, or speed up. So, in case they communicate with her that they want us to slow down or speed up, stand up. My condition is quite coyote. And if we will see her, and then she either goes slow down or speed up.
Okay.
Yeah. Those hands are slow down, stop. Then speed up, stop. And I'll probably be able to walk over there, too. Yeah. Okay, so this is hers, and then you guys have to turn the camera on. Oh, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, we're taking round one.
With that said,
you want to switch to the Yeah. Okay, I just need to make sure my... You need him? Okay. Then I will be doing it. I just need to make sure I turn off my alarms. I just realized we're not late. Okay.
I have already mentioned that this is our regional finale. Every artist you see...
Oh, okay. I need to put up my camera real fast. Yep. Thank you.
Okay. We're going to break a hole.
Okay.
You want to catch the artists as they're coming through.
Do you want me to be near the stage or near the front?
Near the stage and get them as we're hitting the stairs.
Okay, so okay.
Because if we walk from here to there.
Yeah.
And then when you're going around the circle,
okay, so we
when you first walk up,
it's interfering.
When you walk up to the easels when you're going around, first time especially, make sure you get the name plate into the shot so that the moderators know who's on your end.
I'm wondering how she's
going to
have ramp.
Well, no, she said she could do this typical stairs.
Got it. Okay. Are we starting right now?
Follow artists. Great. Check out these cool QR codes here and other places to check out the
Are we starting right now?
Yes.
Okay. I wanted to put the phone up, but that's okay.
They're making nice people. I'm talking. Okay, another thing talking about us.
I think it's probably time to introduce
our artists. Are you ready to meet our artists? All right, can we give it up for our artists as they come to our stage? Make a little room for them, a little plan. Artists, come on down. We'll open our applause for them.
I'm so excited for you.
There's no memory card in it.
It's fine.
No, it won't record it. It's
okay.
No memory card. You don't need to record. You don't need to record it.
Let's try to love that. You guys are eight artists for round one. This Portland artist is currently raising two kids and is currently engaged in collaboration with local schools to enhance campuses with bright, bold educational murals with the help of students and teachers. Gosh, he's a good person. Would you please show all of your love for Jordan Tent? She hopes that one day she can express herself with brushstrokes and colors as easily as if she was talking out loud. I hope you get there too. Please show some love for Olga Bolivar! Angel number three is a full-time muralist and a live event and wedding painter. Yeah, you should get a live a painter for your wedding. Also, no one preps like this artist. Such respect for how much preparation she puts in. Please give it up for Hillary Isaacson. At Easel Mobile. So I could mention all the Seattle-based multimedia themes and wonderfulness, but then she's like, actually, what people want to know is they've got a brace around their neck, and she was internally decapitated. She should be dead. And we're all super happy she's alive. A lovely person. I'm really happy you're alive. Please give it up for Jusana! At Easel number five. An Oregon native whose artistic journey began with a childhood fascination with Saturday morning comics, 80s sci-fi. His work can be found in multiple children's books and video games. So cool. Show some love for Chase Malarty! At Easel number five. They're an avid adventurer, love seeking photos of places they've been, and painting from their explorations. Also, check out the work at Santa Fe Cafe in Burien.
You should. Go by all their work. It's great.
Give a warm welcome for M. Morley! And Easel number seven. One of our, really she's been there for us in Portland. I just cannot say enough about what she's done helping to sponsor our Portland events with Bottle of Bodega. I'll mention that later. She's our beat sponsor and is currently kicking the shit out of cancer. So I have mad respect for that as well. She's gonna win you over with both herself and her painting. Please give it up for Holly Moxley. Okay, last but not least, at Easel number eight, they kind of naturally ran here. Want to be the new wrestling voice? Big fan of bold colors and bright lights. Obsessed with how colors change the emotions we feel when we look at a work of art. Also, check out their hand-painted refurbished flannel shirts. They're rad. You should buy them and wear them. Please give it up for Haley Michelle! Okay, artist, shall we get up there? No one's saying no? Audience, shall we give you a roll? You're gonna let the sweet peach behind me help you walk in a circle? You have one more job, which is to help me get this thing going with that backwards counting. Starting at 10, 9, 8.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Art Battle Northwest Championship. Tonight, we have artists competing from Seattle, Portland, and Tacoma, all vying for a spot in the national championship. We have 20 minutes on the clock, and we've just started round number one with our first eight artists. My name is Morgan Booth, and I'm here with Ariel Hosseini, a well-decorated artist in Art Battle herself. Welcome, Ariel.
Thanks for having me, Morgan.
Very, very stoked to be witnessing this right now. The quality of artists tonight is going to be amazing.
All right, I can see that happening already.
Looking like some really intense green going down by this artist here.
Yeah, Olga's using variations of green, throwing in some white, getting some shades in, some tints. Wow, moving so fast already, 1 minute in.
And looking like we're getting just a few touches of darker green in the bottom there, just giving us that little hint of depth.
Oh yeah, I feel like the art, I'm seeing other canvases in the background already, and everyone's got their background kind of happening. Ooh, nice stroke.
And here we are at this easel, and looks like we have this gorgeous, like, light teal going down on the canvas. And I love when an artist just starts off super intensely with color.
Yeah, that color is very pretty. Definitely one of my favorite colors. And the great bold black background. I'm guessing it's black, or maybe just a darker shade of the turquoise color. Very pretty so far.
I think that is Hillary Isaacson.
Okay. Wow, look at this line work here.
I believe that this is Gusiana, and this is already so good. Like, a 3 minute drawing of an anatomical heart, that's so, so fast. Great execution.
Amazing execution. Like, that is accurate and clean already. I love to see where this goes. I'm kind of seeing like a dagger going through it. Very beautiful.
Yeah, loving the central composition, just very in your face.
Mm-hmm. Nice big bold lines already. That composition is always very satisfying to see. Oh, look at this. Fingers and smudging and wow. Amazing.
I am all about this. This is Chase. And when I was checking out his work earlier, I kind of felt like it had a bit of an Egon Schiele vibe, and like I'm seeing that kind of angularity and angst coming through in this portrait.
Yeah, I feel like it's coming through his fingers, the way he's moving. It's wow. I'm already blown away by this. That angular feel is very, very nice. Great job, Chase.
Such a huge level of intensity to bring to the easel in our first few moments.
Oh, and here we go. We're getting a nice wash over it. Oh, wow.
I feel like Chase heard us, and he's like, you thought that was intense? Just you wait.
You wait. I've just begun. Literally just begun. Like, a couple minutes in. Amazing.
Incredible.
Oh.
Here we are with M, and I forgot that M uses their hands in all of their work. Ugh, it's all coming back to me. I've seen M paint a few times before, and their technique is just mind-blowing.
Oh, wow. M has it going on. Look at this. just adding purple and this vivid orange red color together, it's very daring, because again, muddying those colors could really change the intensity. But they're doing a great job.
And here we are with Holly Moxley from Seattle, and super, super vibrant start from Holly as well. We often see Holly painting animals, so I'm interested to see whether or not we're going to get that on the canvas tonight.
Oh, yeah, I'm seeing a formation of an animal. Do you see it, Morgan?
Oh, there it is. Yeah. A bird?
Yeah, getting a bird, exactly. Very nice. Soft blends on this canvas so far. Not super blended out and not super separated either. Like, it's very nicely put together.
Yeah, I'm loving the way that Holly is creating these small areas of diffusion. Like, we've got super bright colors going on, but then where they meet each other, she's just kind of gently coaxing them together and creating this kind of glow effect.
That glow, it almost gives me a phoenix feeling. We'll see. We'll see where it happens. Ooh. This is cool. Oh, wow. I just saw what this is. That took me a second. Are you seeing it?
Yes. Oh, my God.
Wow.
So,
beautiful.
Like, I feel like that's all I'm going to say. The whole first 10 minutes, I'm going to be like, guys, what? 5 minutes? 8 minutes?
What?
I love the emotion that we're getting from these two characters already.
Yeah, what a really amazing execution already. Like, it's just the beginning, and we have these figures. Like, oh, wow. Very soothing to look at. I love it already.
And that, like, punch of magenta right against the seafoam background and the blue is just so nice.
Very well done. I'm excited to see where that ends up, where it heads.
And here we are with Jordan Tarrant from Portland, and we've actually seen him paint in Seattle, Portland, and San Francisco.
Wow, that's quite a few art battles already. That's amazing. This is really cool. This brush that they used was creating windows and buildings and that architecture that is so nicely detailed with this brush.
I love it, and I can guarantee that that's a DIY brush.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think I've ever seen that. So I've seen similar ones sold, but that one's definitely a little more effective, I would say.
Yeah, you can see where he's like cut back the bristles, and wow, what an interesting implement.
Yeah, I find it so cool to watch so many different artists use tools in different ways. It's really mind opening.
That's my favorite moment, I think, in the stream, when we come around and you just get struck by the painting. And that's definitely what's happening for me here with Olga's piece. So striking.
Yes, I have that same like a look of awe on my face here. The highlights that she's adding in, like, wow, I feel speechless already.
Incredible. And even just that subtle work that she did at the bottom in her first initial strokes with that mid-tone, just giving depth to the scene already.
Yeah, the depth was there even before any details came in. And I think that's really important when you're layering so quickly on a 20-minute painting. That depth is nice when it's already laid out for you before you start your details. Oh my gosh, I love it.
So ghostly.
Yeah. You know, this is like my style for sure. I'm like definitely into this one.
Oh, definitely. It has this like real surrealist lean that is like almost entirely communicated by the strange colors that she's chosen.
Very soft.
Wow. Hillary has done an epic amount of painting since we saw her last.
Yeah. Wow. It's an astronaut. Oh, this is adorable. I love this. Aww.
Incredible. I love even just the thoughtful color placement here with the warm colors, like giving us this light bounce, and then you can see that magenta reflected in the glass of the helmet too. Thoughtful details.
Very thoughtful. So beautifully done. I'm admiring her execution for sure. Those warm tones are just very, very nice. Ooh, detail.
I'm just mesmerized right now.
Really nice.
A lot done from Gusiana as well. I love the intensity of this background, really helping the heart to just pop off with contrast.
Oh yeah, super daring, a nice deep rich blues in the blocks. It's amazing how much has changed since we came around, and she still has that same shape and form that she had earlier. So that's nice to see that it's nicely executed as well. Wow.
I wonder if we're gonna get any little pops of color within this piece. I'd love to see maybe like a hit of red on the jewel of the sword or something.
Ooh, yeah, that would look really cool. I wonder what's going to happen. The intensity is really nice, though. I like the choice that she made with the contrast.
And something that's interesting to note about Gusiana's work as well is that she describes her work as being a part of a journey of emotional healing because she deals with various chronic illnesses.
Oh, wow. Beautiful. So well done. I love when art has this second meaning that's, you know, not always known by the viewer. I think that's so important in artwork.
Wow. I'm so surprised at, like, how much he's covered that green that was so intense before, but he's just allowing little bits of it to come through and to cool down the portrait.
Yeah. Like, where did the green go? I see it. I see it ever so slightly. This has been like a little wild ride. We've been watching him paint and it changed so much.
Chase is the layer master with this painting.
Yeah.
Like, how are you layering all of that? You don't have time for the paint to dry, but somehow.
That's crazy. I think he did start with charcoal, I believe. But he's layered it so well. I'm mind boggled by that. That's great.
And continued wonderfulness from M. My favorite thing about M's technique is how you get like this soft blend from the roundness of the fingers, but you get so much texture from the heavy application.
Right, that is a very tricky thing to do. You're right, the finger itself, it creates that softness. It's a tricky tool. I mean, some people are very careful, very comfortable using their fingers and confident, and it looks like M, they've been doing this for a while, so it's turning out wonderfully.
Like, it's such a mature painting style to then witness it be done by finger painting. Like, that's got to be something that the audience is massively engaging with.
Absolutely. Like, you're right, it is a very technical painting to be doing with your fingers, so dibs on them.
Ooh, I love the sharpness of these feathers.
That blue really brings in some contrast as well. I'm really enjoying that.
Yeah, fully like phoenix rising energy.
Yeah, it's very vivid, very alive. Jumping off the canvas, leaving that yellow tone in the background too. I really like that choice.
All right, heading into our final 6 minutes of round number one of the Art Battle Northwest Championships. Once again, the top two artists from this round and the top two artists from our next round will be moving forward into a third and final round. So get ready to vote and go to artbattle.com/AB2631, the link that is in the description of this video. Oh my gosh, Haley.
Wow.
The blacks just like bring everything together.
My jaw is like dropped. Like I'm just out.
Absolutely epic.
Very, very well executed. Like she must have had this done a couple times, because to lay those colors in the correct place, to get that composition, the angles of that face, it's so tricky. So like, wow. I'm just wow.
I have to agree with you, Ariel. I think that this is definitely something that Haley has practiced before coming. And just goes to show how badly these guys want to win it. They are coming prepared, coming in hot.
Very beautifully done. Oh, this is looking really cool. This brush, I'm obsessed with this brush. It's so
Me
cool.
too.
It's so neat.
I'm obsessed with the brush, and I'm also really impressed with the opacity that he's gotten with this seafoam color layering over top of the black.
Yeah, I mean, he's probably just very lightly just bloop. Touching it, canvas, bloop, 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 little spots.
So, nice. So good. Whoa.
Nice. Wow.
Totally didn't expect that. Absolutely nope. Love it.
That is so cool.
That's such a fun part of Art Battle where you're like, they did what?
Yeah. You're like, no way. How could that happen? We love it, though.
So, so great. All right, just a few minutes remaining on this round.
Goodness, the squeegee.
Oh, I love it. I love seeing like strange tools being incorporated. And I think that that's just like a shower squeegee.
Yeah, so cool. And she got the straightest, cleanest lines out of it. That otherwise would be really tricky with if you had like a nice, thin, round brush to get a straight line in this totally. Wet paint. Like, that makes so much sense. That is so cool.
Yeah, Olga is such a pro.
Amazing, amazing artist, yeah. Ooh, oh my.
I think it's interesting the way that Hillary has created this opportunity for like organic paint movement in the top corner here, and it's really contrasting the tighter painting in the bottom.
Yeah, it's giving me a very graphic style with the astronaut, and then this very, yeah, right, like this organic flow in the background, and that cool tone, that blue she added, it makes such a nice shadow in that astronaut figure.
Back over with Gufiana, and these highlights are just bringing so much great 3D quality here.
Yes, that's like the icing on the cake for me. I love that part, watching people put highlights into a painting.
Oh, absolutely. I totally relate.
Gorgeous.
And speaking of highlights, yeah. Check out Chase. Ugh, that little dot that he just put on the nose. So
yeah,
great.
That changes everything. Oh, I want to see this in the right lighting. Oh, wow.
Yes, I'm so happy that we got the catch light. That's my favorite part of any portrait.
Yep, that highlight, little twinkle in the eye. It's gorgeous. Just wow.
And such an interesting use of color too, like that muted green and then the pop of the darker red. Just mm-hmm. fantastic. Wow, Em.
Oh, they've gone above and beyond with this. There are flowers in the foreground. Oh, wow.
Like, how is this piece not muddy? It's incredible.
You have to such a light finger touch. Like, to even think of finger touch versus paint brush touch, it's like very tricky. Like, I'm impressed.
Me too. Awesome. More great catchlight action from our Phoenix by Holly here. The movement in this piece, the upward flowing movement, is beautiful.
Yeah, she really embodied the flow of like flames. If that's what she's going for, it definitely embodies that. And it's really nice. Like, very, very sweet.
so impactful. So impactful, this piece. Oh my gosh, check out the tiny little pink brush marks in the eyelashes, the details.
Oh my gosh, yeah, wow.
All right, getting into our countdown now.
Oh, that was fast.
No one can tell this art more than me. No one can love you better, artists. It's just all of us here. Hey, audience, you gotta help me. Help them end this strong. We're gonna count it back again, starting in 10, 9.
I think we can all agree that that was a beyond epic first round for the Northwest Championship. Absolutely blown away by the quality of the art and also the breadth of styles. Ariel, any favorite moments, favorite pieces from this round?
Well, that's a really tough question, Morgan. But everyone has their own style, and I really love that everyone executed their own thing. I'm definitely a fan of the pop art style portraits. They were a three-quarter angle, very, very cool. And that ship was really nice. Color scheme was really cool. I think it was Chase with the portrait that just kept evolving. Everyone had such a unique thing to throw on the canvas today, so it's going to be tough.
Yeah, it's going to be so difficult to choose who to vote for. I'm having difficulty trying to figure out who I'm going to vote for, but that doesn't excuse us from our art democracy responsibilities here. Now, voting is open, so it's time to go to artbattle.com/AB2631, the link that is in the description of this video. It's also popped up on the screen right now. And the top two artists from round number one and the top two artists from round number two will be moving forward into a four-artist final showdown where one artist will be crowned the winner, and that one will be moving forward to the U.S. National Championship taking place later this year. Right now, we are checking out Bernadette Enrique, who is one of our exhibition painters up on the stage. In the background there, we have Charles Burt, two well-decorated artists in the Art Battle Northwest scene. So be sure to continue to watch their paintings evolve. And you can also bid on them in silent auction as the auction is live right now for round number one and for these exhibition paintings as well. You don't need to be in the room to bid and collect these pieces. We will ship them to you. All right, we will be back very shortly with round number two and another epic array of champion artists in this championship event. 8 artists, 20 minutes, more blank canvas, ready to be turned into super incredible paintings. Stay tuned.
Thank you.
passes away. That is a quick way to bypass this whole process of trying to get over. So if you know which number it was, you just apply there. Otherwise, keep it open for a while. So that'll be the result as well. Multiple ways. Got it? I hope you apply the text with the number. Sorry for the inconvenience, but we'll get there. We've got time.
Thank you.
I want to work a bench. That's what I want to do. But there's too much money in it. And I have school. And other responsibilities.
There is, if you want to do, like, corporate.
See, the thing is, I'm fine with that. My friend, she works for the health and the new Ritz-Carlton in Portland. And that's what she does. And then she has another company that hires her that flies around the world. So...
Monster Dan, check out Monster Dan stickers, that are amazing. Massey, Higgins, Seattle, bottle that will take a portable beautiful palette and turn it away. Put them in there from the beginning. Bottle will take it in the game of Portland. And don't miss your gathering to come as a result of that as well. And of course, Jack Daniels for just tonight and special event. Please thank our sponsors one more time. If you would like to sponsor something in the future, you don't sponsor, we would love to help. Hope there's 3,000 people watching that. With that said, oh my goodness, artists, are you ready to be introduced? Audience, are you ready to meet our round two? Audience, are you ready to meet our round two artists? I'm excited. Let's go ahead and welcome to the stage our round two artists. Come on in. Make a little room for them. Let's introduce them. At easel number one, basically we're picking right there. This artist, actually a great story. Showed up in Art Battle, did not plan to paint, did not know she was painting, put her name in a bucket. We had a spare spot, we wrote her name, she made it to the easel and won with no preparation whatsoever. There's only one person that can be. Please give it up for Esther! At easel number two. Yes, you can take people's art home tonight, but this is one of our only artists who you can actually become a piece of their art. He's a tattoo artist over at Golden Rule in Silverdale. He also does murals. Someone's asking again. Please show some love for Francois! At easel number three, he's got a passion for art, moments, brush. He does all kinds of art, but big fan of pet portraits. He's got a pet portrait done. She's told me that all the money, a good chunk of the money you spend on that art is going to go to feed those pets. You gotta love that. Also, she likes to make fun of my dancing. Can I please do that too? Please give it up for Lyra! Also, hey, Lyra's family. You're fine. Okay, at easel number four. Let's do this one about back in the art, back in the painting. Third time now doing a 3D resin painting production of Dragon's Miniatures. Nice. Give it up for Liz Koopman. They won last year. They won this event last year. That gets them back here right away. An incredible talent and an incredible person. Show some love for Frida. At easel number six, someone who wants to remain anonymous. Does not want you knowing much about their backstory. Sometimes described as a trickier Dr. Seuss. And when pressed, will admit, he's a huge old waffles. Please welcome Cater the Alchemist. At easel number seven. Inspired by nature, also great aerialist, and is here for a good time. A veteran of our battle. Please give a warm welcome for Janae Velasco. And our last new artist for the night is a self-taught artist from Bend, Oregon, ready to share her art on a wider basis in hopes that someone will resonate with her pieces. That could be you. You and her could resonate through art tonight. Yes. Give it up for Madeline Kokos. Okay, you know the rules. You know the game. I hope you're having a good time. I think it's amazing. I think it's worth doing. I'm glad you're here to enjoy it. I'm glad you're here to count backwards from 10, 9.
Hello and welcome back everyone to our second round of the Art Battle Northwest Championships. We are here watching artists representing Seattle, Portland, and Tacoma all vying for the spot to move forward into the U.S. National Championship later this year. We are in our second round and we have eight incredible artists with 20 minutes only on the clock. All right. My name is Morgan Booth, and I am here with Ariel Hosseini, who is a very well-decorated art battle artist herself, who also painted in the Canadian Championship. So welcome, Ariel.
Thanks, Morgan. Welcome back to round two.
Who are we checking out right now? Right now we have Esther Short up here, and I think that we're getting maybe a portrait action. I thought I saw a little bit of a sketch going on there.
Yeah, nice vivid blues happening, solid background. Oh, and quite the opposite here with Francois.
Ooh, I'm loving the way that all of this is coming together. We've just got some really beautiful cloudy tones kind of interacting right now.
I wonder what's happening here. Oh, I'm seeing a reference picture, but I won't spoil it. It's looking nice already. I love this towel that he's using to remove color. Soften it too.
Looking like we're getting some really nice introduction of planes of the face. We're getting some proportions established there.
Yeah, beautifully done. Using that line to sketch out on top of that soft background. I think it's a smart move to soften the background there. Oh.
This is so cool, the dual portrait of person and pupper.
Oh, it is a doggo. Aw, this is adorable. Oh, this is gonna be a very neat painting also when it comes together. Laying down all the shadow work here.
Oh, this is looking fantastic as well. I love the rosy tones that we're getting here.
Yeah, it's I like seeing when artists bring this down to their laps, get comfy, and this very, very sketchy style happening. Very pretty, pretty so far.
And the use of the pastel is looking fantastic as well.
Yeah, I believe there's a acrylic background. I'm not too sure what the background is, but it's a nice way to fill out the background and have the option to sketch in with pencils, pens, pastels. It gives you a whole different feel on your piece.
And I feel like Liz has got some really careful time management strategies that she's employing right now, taking care of most of the detail work and establishing her face right away, and then moving into the larger portions.
Oh yeah, super clever to get through those details in the beginning, and you feel satisfied when you move on to the bigger stuff. This is a cute octopus.
From the one and only Frida Haas. Frida is the defending Northwest Regional Champion. I had the privilege to hang out with her and talk with her and see her paint at US Nationals last year. And she is just such an innovative artist. Like, check out the bubbles that she's got going on right now in the paint. I think that she's got a medium that like disrupts the surface tension of the paint and creates that effect.
Oh my goodness, that is so cool you got to meet her. Like, this is awesome. Yeah, maybe it's like silicone oil or something, but that's like really
neat. I think that's exactly it. I think you have it on the nose there. But yeah, it's such an innovative painter, and like just such a celebratory use of color from Frida always too.
the intricacy here, the color, the layout of where the color is going. She knows exactly where everything is going to end up, and wow, I'm really excited to see that all come together. Oh,
such tight line work from Cater here. So super, super clean and like really sharp as well. And then we have that green tone moving upwards.
Oh, what nice line work. Oh my goodness. Super satisfying to watch. And extreme detail in like a couple minutes time. I believe this person may be a street artist.
I would definitely agree with you, and I'm just picturing like how many sketchbooks Cater must have completed in his life to be able to execute this style so quickly.
Yeah, that's so accurate and beautifully done. The pressure on the brush gives it nice thin, thick lines. They definitely know what they're doing.
So great. And here we are with Janae. And they are working on a portrait that is just looking so peaceful.
Oh yeah, beautiful soft colors, bold, but also soft at the same time. They have a great option to choose these colors and have that nice silhouette happening there too.
And I think that the seafoam color might be the most popular color on the paint table. So many artists tonight have chosen to use it.
Oh yeah, I would say it's definitely one of my favorite colors. I would totally be drawn to using it too. It's nice. It's a nice little thing to throw in there or execute your entire painting with too. It's such a beautiful, whimsy color.
Exactly. It definitely lends a level of whimsy, and it's a very commanding color. It just really draws your eye to it.
Yeah, I really like how it blends into other colors too. Like if you're using the same values, you have this nice transition with that seafoam green.
Mm-hmm.
100% would definitely throw that on my palette.
And here we are with Madeline Coast, who describes her work as being surreal and dark and emotive. And that is such a vibe, and I'm here for it.
Mm-hmm, same. Really beautiful use of color already here too, for her values in that purple magenta tone. I'm excited to see where this goes.
And I'm liking those cheek highlights already. It's always interesting to see how artists build a portrait. Some people kind of establish the harder parts of the features right away, like the eye sockets and the eyebrows and the lips and things like that. And then other artists will be more concerned with the planes of the face and how light is hitting it before they go into details.
Yeah, there's the either or, and then there's people who just don't have any rules and they just go in with portraits and you're like, whoa. Yeah, it's a lot of planning mentally when you're doing a portrait. And you're an amazing portrait artist, Morgan, so you probably have your way of doing it too. It's really cool to see.
Yeah, all artists just build their pieces in their own fashion that they've come up with. And as you were saying, it's like figuring out all of those components and then also doing it in front of 500 people in 20 minutes.
Probably the hardest part.
Right?
Oh, gosh. Oh, wow.
This looks fantastic. I love the sharpness of the features.
Mm-hmm. It's so very, very nice. I would say this is great art for any space, like walls, anywhere. Like, I just feel like this would fit in so well. It's really well placed, all of the colors.
I feel like if I collected this piece, it would make me want to be bolder every day. Like, this piece in my bedroom and be like, okay, I'm gonna be that girl today.
Yeah, I agree. It does have that feeling that you wear it and look at it. Oh my goodness.
Francois.
Well, we all know who this is, I hope.
Yeah. What a great likeness.
A really good likeness, yeah. Wow.
He's really captured Dolly here so well. And I can't even believe that we're only halfway through.
Yeah, that's insane because it's very well done and we're getting this intensity in the eyeballs, the brows, like, really, really good.
Absolutely epic. You can really tell that all of these artists have come in with a game plan.
Oh, I'm really connecting to this piece. I recently discovered something similar between Dolly and I, not to toot my own horn, but it was really cool to hear his experiences and how he's created art. So yeah, I have a whole new respect for Dolly.
Yeah, such an iconic artist. I'm also doing some work that's inspired by Dolly.
Oh, awesome. That's so cool. Yeah, super inspiring.
And such a great portrait to choose of him too. It's so iconic. You have the iconic mustache, the intensity of the super, super wide eyes, and I feel like the audience is definitely gonna connect that.
Oh yeah, for sure. Oh, this is so cute.
I feel like Lyra is gonna get so many commissions after this. Like, everyone's gonna want a painting like this of them with their dog. It's so special.
You're right. That is such a nice, pretty thing to do. A nice piece to have. Oh, this is adorable.
And so calm, too. Like, it makes me wonder whether or not maybe this dog is a service animal or, like, an emotional support animal.
It almost seems like they're laying in a little path or on the lawn or in a garden.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Back over with Liz. I had the pleasure of seeing Liz paint in Portland when she won her event, and she just has such a unique way of building her pieces and switching between media.
This is interesting. Yeah, the media, the mixed media that's happening is really, really cool. It just seems so fun and alive, and it's done with so many different materials.
And I really like how she's mixing like softer tones with those sharper lines too. Like, we've got a lot of diffused color going on in the hair and the cheeks, and then we've got some strong brows and eyelashes going on. I already talked to
them about it. Super, super impactful. Oh, ow. Jeez. Oh, look at the coil in the tentacle. It's just so nice. Oh, I want to hug it.
And the way that they're, like, wrapping and kind of folding over themselves, too, really just kind of underscores that sensation of floating.
Mm-hmm. It's so well done. I'm just, like, also speechless for this one. Wow.
Back over with Cater here.
Oh, this is so fun.
Such, like, a strong style and ability to execute. And, like, I often, especially with illustrators, I'll talk about the way that an artist's hand is recognizable and the way that they lay down the weight of their line work. And Cater is just such an identifiable style.
Absolutely. Like, that line weight is breathing. It creates so much depth and refinement. And this is such a cool piece. There's a moon. There's mushrooms. There's a third eye on this character. It's so fun to watch.
So many, like, interesting little details. Back over with Janae. Are these going to be stars? I'm going to be so excited if they're stars.
Yeah, I think so. Oh, this is so pretty.
Janae's work always has such an incredible sense of fantasy and whimsy, but in this very like calming way. I would also encourage anyone who's watching this stream, when you get a chance to vote, to go to the link that's at the bottom of our screen and in the description. In addition to being able to vote there, you can also see profiles on all of these artists and where to follow them on social media. So you can be able to compare what their studio work looks like with their live work. All right, just 4 minutes remaining on our competition clock here in the second round. And voting is open. Make sure that you go to artbattle.com/AB2631. And the top two artists from our first round and the top two artists from this round will be moving forward into a four artist final showdown. So make sure that you vote for the artist that you want to see paint again. Not only should you be thinking about the visual quality of the piece and what you like best, but also whose performance you enjoyed the most and who you want to see rock the easel again. This piece evolved so quickly.
Oh yeah, these flowers are such pretty little additions. The two tones of blue I really like. It's very nice. It's very soothing as well to look at.
And then that hit of surrealist element with the florals being eyes.
Oh, yeah, okay, I'm just seeing that now. Oh, how cool.
And the eyes are open on the flowers, but closed on the figure. Oh. Love it.
Love that. That's cool. Ooh. This character's got some shades on now.
Just continuing with the coolness evolution and inspiring us all to be cooler.
Yep, this is the coolest I think anyone can be. I'm loving this. Those little additions, horizontal lines that they added was really, really nice. Like, so subtle, such a little thing to add, but it adds so much.
And for me, it almost feels like glitchy. Like, mm-hmm. it leans into the kind of techie vibe that's going on with the character.
Whoa. Just whoa.
That the pink that's behind the face.
Yeah, and everything. Intertwined in the face, too. Like, just really, really cool. It was executed in the first, 8 minutes? Of the paint of the battle, and the refinement is really bringing it all together.
I agree, and that's such a considered battle strategy too, to get all of your major components established up front and then just take your time towards the end.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's a full house.
Yeah, definitely a big crowd moment here. And these guys will have so much difficulty choosing who to vote for.
Yep, this is a tough one. These past two rounds have been just unbelievable talent.
Whoa. And I think throughout the entire night, everyone's been really not afraid of color. Everyone's been really intentional and intense with their color choices.
Yeah, you're right. Everyone did play with color quite a bit. You know, it's really nice to look at these things from afar and just have an impact, even without knowing exactly what you're seeing until you get close. Plays a big part.
Oh, there's wow. So many wonderful subtleties in this piece.
Mm-hmm. I really like this one. It's just a different version of a portrait. Okay, you can say the same about this one, totally different version of the portrait.
All right, let's give it up for our audience, please! You did so good! You're not telling the shit! All right. girl than it is you. Audience, here is what is up next. I'm told that after voting, I'm told that voting normally is how we're going to vote. And so we will vote on this round and last round. The last round should still be open. Once we feel like we have an obvious winner, we'll close it. So we're going to basically, once it's clear that we've got a top four, we'll close it and announce who's moving on to our last round. Just so you know, we don't trust technology anymore, as no artist should. So we're going to move into the auction.
They're so good.
The paintings.
Yeah, they are. I really like the last one. The one that was right before it, the woman that's wearing, yeah, the pink hair. I love it. Yeah. It's so good.
Makes sense? Yeah. We've all been great. Thanks for patience. Artists, you've been better. Like, really, those are incredible. So, one more time for our artists, please! Get your votes in, we'll be patient until we know we're going to be a winner, and hopefully that'll be very soon. So thank you so much, take back with you, Jessica.
Just incredible. Our second round just blew me away. Another just absolutely amazing paintings. It's going to be so difficult to choose who to vote for. Ariel, any thoughts? Any favorite moments?
Oh, yeah. This was a tough challenge. Sorry, a tough round as well. Was a challenge as well. But, you know, execution, everyone, again, came with their style and really pushed through that 20 minutes. Dolly is looking great. Octopus is looking great. This fashionista figure is looking great. Like, it's definitely going to be a tough one. Really into Cater's style as well. That was pretty cool.
Oh, absolutely. Just like these guys really hit it out of the park and were so completely true to their styles as well. I really don't. Sometimes when you get to the higher levels of competition, you can end up seeing artists that kind of tend to play to the crowd in an effort to garner votes. But I feel like everyone really stuck super, super true to their own style. And it just, that kind of authenticity really connects with the crowd as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's really nice to see that everyone's having their moment on stage here, painting with, you know, their true style and bringing that to the table. Even just having the opportunity to show your work is just such a cool thing. And yeah, I'm really into this one here.
And voting is open at artbattle.com/AB2631. So make sure that you get your votes in, and we will see the top two from round number one and the top two from round number two moving forward into a four artist final showdown. So make sure you get those votes in. We'll only be counting them for just a few minutes, and stay tuned. We'll be back with our finalist announcement in just a few minutes. And for anyone who is curious to check out the work of us, your commentators, you can find our Instagrams in the description box. And I urge you to check out Ariel at Dream Paint Art. She is an absolutely incredible artist. Who creates really incredible work inspired by her dreams and with this wonderful surrealist quality. So make sure that you go check out Ariel at Dream Paint Art. All right, we will be back with our finalist announcement in just a few minutes.
this one is actually charged.
I don't remember.
I'm gonna go find someone.
Thank you. They might have added another one. I know. It worked the first time, and I was like, can't you just, like, reset it? But it didn't do anything. Weird. Yeah.
Where is free so I can film our first part?
Okay.
Good question.
The bidding will be moved over to design an auction style, right? Where you just write technology, right? Amazing. He's gonna write your bids on a piece of paper next to the art. It's all gonna be back there. Mud. I was trying to call you Mud, then that's not. Mud, some big pictures. Okay. That was my suspense building, giving people a chance to file in. From round one! Our first artist is moving on. At easel number three, Hillary Isaacson! I guess she will be here before. I guess she can prepare like crazy.
One more artist
from round one. Only one, even though they're all incredible.
Our artists were incredible, and you should get on the page because you are part of
Okay, finally. Okay. Okay. Give it up for all 16 of our artists, please.
Yeah.
You were great. They were all good people. Okay, with that said, we'll come right back here as soon as they're ready to get this last round going. We're having the championship for the season. Take it away, keep doing it, watch.
And our finalists have been announced and officially moving forward into the final round of the Art Battle Northwest Championships will be from round number one, Hillary Isaacson and Jordan Tarrant. Hillary did that super amazing portrait of the astronaut looking into space, holding a flower, so thoughtful. And Jordan did the painting of the woman with the buildings coming off of her hair with so much amazing texture and innovative technique. And then from round number four, or round number two, moving forward is Frida Haas with that super vibrant and bold octopus painting, and Francois with the iconic and well-executed Dali portrait. I am so excited to see these four moving forward into the final round. We're gonna get an opportunity to see these guys paint again and take on yet another blank canvas. We always say the best way to win art battle is to do the best painting of your life in only 20 minutes and then do it again. So we will see these four artists stepping back up to the easels in just a few minutes, so be sure to stay tuned.
We'll be right back.
Now, that's where all of our bidding is going to happen. It's on paper. All the voting sitting on our fans' computers. Okay, let's go ahead and welcome back our four painters. Hey, 5-4, Raging Kings, round four, round three. Go ahead and come on down. Let's give a big round of applause, please.
Welcome back, everyone, to our third and final round of the Northwest Championships for Art Battle. One artist will emerge the winner of tonight's event, and that artist will qualify and move forward to the U.S. National Championship, taking place later this fall. Right now, we have competing Hillary Isaacson, Jordan Tarrant, Frida Haas, and Francois. With 20 minutes on the clock and a new blank canvas, these guys have got a lot on the line. My name is Morgan Booth, and I'm here with the one and only Ariel Hosseini. Hey, Ariel.
Hey, 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 look at this execution.
So crazy. Everyone's just like putting their whole body into painting these big pieces. We're seeing a lot of like broad strokes and long arm movements.
Yeah, this is exciting. This canvas is probably the same size as me. But these guys are gonna make it happen.
Ooh, an interesting start here from Jordan with this blue.
Yeah, not quite the entire canvas, so maybe creating texture or some asymmetry.
Or maybe even like a sneaky horizon line, and we just don't know yet.
We don't know yet, right?
Maybe he's gonna turn it. I feel like that would be really difficult to turn these canvases, though. They're so large.
They're huge, yeah. Yeah, definitely a new challenge. You know, you get a bigger canvas. You still have 20 minutes. That's all you get, but you do have more space to work with, which is intimidating.
Oh, definitely. As soon as we saw these canvases hit the easels, I was like, wow, that is next level, big league stuff. And I can't wait to see how these guys handle that extra challenge.
Right. These are big league artists, so they need definitely a bigger space to express their new piece. And yeah, there's a lot of cool, different, unique techniques coming around here.
And Frida, I feel like, is going to be doing a portrait. And I love that she's just showing us her breadth of ability across different subject matter.
Yes, I'm enjoying how she's lifting the paint to create highlight instead of painting in a highlight. We were just talking about portraiture in the last round, and this is another unique way to attack a portrait.
And that's such a great thing to point out too, about how she's taking away the paint, and it gives a softness to the way that she's adding that lightness.
Yeah, it's really smooth and a little more like realistic in that way.
Ooh, I can't wait to see what Francois does in this round. I wonder whether or not he's going to be taking on another iconic personality.
Yeah, I'm seeing a face already, and it's slightly recognizable. I feel like as we go, we're going to figure out who it is. Oh, that might be an afro. That might be hair. We'll see.
Definitely thinking afro. And he is the only artist that has turned the painting to landscape and is taking on this wider compositional area.
Yes, he did. He is the only artist doing that. Yes, it's really nice. I mean, for a portrait, you get more space. Oh, I'm seeing the reference shot here. Nice.
Oh, ho, ho. I'm like holding back from totally spoiling it in case other people are not catching on yet.
Mm-hmm. We'll leave it. We'll leave it to be. Oh, very nice edge here to cast that shadow. The eyelid.
Yeah, totally. Giving a little bit of weight to that brow, too.
Mm-hmm. Very satisfying to watch.
I'm just noticing Hillary's awesome painting like work onesie. It's so cool.
Oh, yeah. I love that. I've been hunting for one, too. That looks so comfy, and just, you don't have to think about anything when you're painting, about your clothes at all. They're just like comfy.
And the crowd has got to be loving that too. She's so like visually identifiable as an artist, and I can guarantee that she's wiping some brushes on her pants as she goes, and like the crowd loves that stuff. It's a part of the performance.
And yeah, I mean, that makes it so much more fun to see the artist kind of just get let loose, and it gives a more relaxed feel as well, right? You're not just kind of super hyper-focused on your painting, and you are art, so that's really nice to see.
And Hillary taking on a portrait in this round as well. We've got definitely portrait-heavy going on right now.
Yeah, some impactful portraits, high contrast. Everyone's got some form of portrait happening. She's moving through it.
I'm really enjoying the organic quality of all of this dripping paint that she's got going on.
Mm-hmm. For hair, for background texture, and she's moving through this movement here. It looks like maybe a shoulder or clothing. Very nice. Oh.
So awesome. I love the way that Jordan's established this. I feel like I still have hope for a landscape.
Yeah.
I feel like it's a 2-in-1.
Yeah, I'm seeing what you're saying. Yes. I'm getting like a tree line. I don't want to spoil it either, but yeah, the portrait's coming out really cool too. Oh, it's exciting.
Yeah, this we're in portrait battle for our final round of the Northwest Championships, and these guys are bringing out all the stops, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm. Portrait battle, for sure. I like the paint that he's using here. It's almost inky. It might be an ink, like an acrylic ink. Very, very opaque. So moving it around should be fun, but it's looking nice. Very nice color.
Yeah, I always love seeing how artists load up their brush.
Mm-hmm.
And Jordan, you're right. Jordan's application here is to lay down and then move it around. He's not reloading the brush every time. And I think that is probably a advantage in terms of time too.
Oh yeah, it just keeps everything flowing and you're in the movement. Wow. Talk about movement.
So nice. The glow on the cheekbone in Frida's portrait is just fantastic.
Oh, it's very, very beautiful. Yeah, she's moving through this painting and having a cool effect on that glow, you're right.
I love the way you said that, that she's moving through the painting. It does feel like almost like a collaborative process between her and the piece. She's kind of assessing what it needs and like she's like so involved in the piece. It feels like a dance.
Mm-hmm. It is like a dance. Yeah, you're right. Oh, wow.
And the strong shape of that circle being put in there too. Interesting design element.
Yeah, this is in like 10 minutes time, 9 minutes time. It's wow.
Well, like, there's anything,
yeah.
There's a reason why Frida is the defending champion and she did not come to play around.
Not at all.
She wants that title again.
it looks really good. It looks really, really good. Oh, nice.
All right, I think it's evident enough that we can talk about it now. This Jimmy portrait is just looking so sick.
Very cool. I'm enjoying this palette knife. He's pulling in color, creating texture. Very cool.
Yeah, the movements with the knife are like so visceral.
Palette knives scare me. I always feel like I'm going to pierce the canvas. Oh, wow. So good, though.
One of our other commentators, whenever he sees a palette knife come out, he goes, ah, it's the artist's sword.
Yes, I've heard that.
And shout out to Tyson. But now I can't help but think of that every time I see one. And it really does feel like a weapon that they're wielding. Like, I think it definitely takes some bravery as an artist to be someone that uses a palette knife, because you have to have such good control and also be comfortable with relinquishing a little bit of control and having more organic marks.
Exactly. It's a battle of both. It's that control and non-control. And the fear of ripping through a canvas, that's my biggest fear. But it's really cool when you know how to use it.
Ooh, is this a metallic that's making its way? I feel like that's a copper. It's hard to see, hard to catch a metallic on camera sometimes. But I feel like that's a reflective.
It might be, yeah. See how the camera angle goes.
And this is an interesting pose for our portrait as well, kind of looking over the shoulder.
Mm-hmm. It's a different, unique pose. I'm loving the splatter here, all the splatter of paint.
And this thick application too, it feels like oil, but I'm looking over and I'm... No, it's got to be acrylic. She's just using it like oil, like really playing up a thick application and butteriness and playing with mediums.
Yeah, I can see. Yeah, I can see that oil aspect, right? But it's nice to use that thick acrylic and have that feeling of oil. It's very, very pretty on her canvas here. It's working well.
Moving back over to Jordan here. Wow, that's so unexpected.
Yeah, it's a lot of color we've got in now. And on top of this purple, it's wow. Lots of texture.
Big impact. And another artist that's really embracing the palette knife.
Oh yes, the sword. Sorry, copywritten. Oh my goodness, very cool.
I'm enjoying how textural and bold and colorful the face and the purple component are versus the more minimalist approach to the forest and that stark, stark black that he's got going on for the shadow.
Mm-hmm. I'm really looking forward to if this painting will change. Oh, look at this.
I think my favorite part of this piece so far is that hit of teal underneath the chin.
Yep, I agree. I also love that bold red in the cheekbone and the upper lip. It really establishes the shapes and forms of the face so simply.
Oh my gosh, and just as we're talking about it, she brought that hit of that color into a line over the shoulder, and it's just harmonizing so well.
Yeah, color harmony, just again, it looks like she's just part of the painting at this point. Her movements, the way she's moving her brush, everything, it just all in one.
So epic. Wow, it's going to be a really tough round to judge. I know that we've said that every round, but that's because it's true. We're at championship level. This is the difficulty that we have as the audience at this level of competition. Is it's hard to choose because the artists are so awesome.
Yeah, and it's also going to be tough. We've got four separate, unique, different portraits. So it's going to be down to like what people feel is the most impactful, what really, what they're drawn to. There's so many factors that come with painting portraits. And yeah, it's really cool to watch. Wow, this is cool.
I think that Jordan chose really well by changing the orientation of his canvas. It allows him to create something that feels really expansive.
Yeah, and Jimi Hendrix, the hair. The hair is what it's about, and the fact that he got the option to extend the hair into this painting, the way it's set like off to the side, it works really well. Ooh, the paint splatter.
So fun. Like, you liked the paint sword. Wait until you see this.
We had to come up with a name for that one. We'll figure it out.
Ooh, and I think that this is now calling back to Hillary's first round painting that was very referential to space. Looks like we're getting some galaxy components.
Yeah, some starry hair. I'm liking that a lot. Ooh.
And the way that some of the stars are kind of bleeding as well is a really interesting element.
Oh yeah, throwing in the darkness for the eyes, standing far back. I like that she stood back like that. It really gives you a clearer view of what you're looking at.
And here's that brush.
What a cool brush.
Ooh, what's that?
It looks like a tower. Could be a tower.
You can just tell that these guys are locked in with such intensity as the clock ticks down with less than 4 minutes remaining in our final round of the Northwest Championship.
Oh yeah, everyone's hyper focused. Trying to get these final details in, and so concentrated. The reference photo right there. Very, very cool.
Yeah, all of these artists are just like totally in their own world with the piece. And you can tell that the crowd has just kind of fallen away for them. It's so nice seeing Jordan's piece just off to the side in this way. It really gives you an opportunity to be able to appreciate all of the texture that he has going on.
Yeah, Jordan definitely took some steps here to be as diverse in one piece as possible, but it's all tied in so well. It's, you know, pretty tricky to get all these different textures and lines together and create a cohesive painting, but I feel like he's pulled it off.
That's such a great point. It does feel like he has a convergence of different styles, and I think that that's really indicative of his style in general. It has this kind of adventurous quality to it.
Yeah, that's the word, adventurous. Yeah, it's very nice. It's dreamy and vivid all at once. It's very cool. Very cool, unique style here.
And with 90 seconds left on the clock, he's just adding in his final tiny little details here. I'm really appreciative that he's kept so much of that stark darkness. I think it provides the perfect contrast to all of the action that he's got going on everywhere else.
Oh yeah, I agree. And those special brush, that really cool texture brush. I'm excited to see where that ends up. Oh.
Fantastic. What a strong image from Freedom.
Oh yeah, like the amount of color she's used here, it's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Oh, look at this, time for outlines even. Oh,
what?
Like, amazing.
I already really liked it.
Yeah.
And then that just like added this level of refinement.
This, yeah, just adds this tiny little highlight on the ear and the earring, like, oh. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
Just so thoughtful. All right, getting into our countdown here in just a few moments.
Oh my gosh, here we are again!
Not gonna work.
Help us out, my audience. Finishing out our last round with 10, 9, 8, 7.
This is the death that is right. Oh! We're gonna throw a sweater in here once we figure out who the winner is. I already gave him a chance.
Are you the first? That is it. The painting for the season is over. There's only a couple of days left to be done. Artists, you're great. You're great. Thank you so much, artists, for being part of this. All 16 of you. Go ahead and put your mark on those. Audience, as soon as we have a winner that's sort of obvious, we will announce that, which means you all get to vote one last time. You get to bid on paintings by our amazing synthetic auction system. And basically, we'll close that out right after we announce winners. So pretty soon, we announced last call a minute ago, so we're doing our last pours right about now. You might have another minute or two if you're really sneaky. Otherwise, oh my gosh. There's one thing left to do, which is crown a winner. So get those votes in. And also, of course, one more time, for all 16 of our artists, please show them some love right now for me. Are you okay? It's like an interview. It really is. Like, including our artists who were in the TV shows. Thank you, right? All right, with that, I'll come back as soon as I can. Way too long to tell you who the winner is.
Until then, we got a couple
more sweet beats for you from DJ Nightwatch. Take it away. Thank you. I have to say, I am just blown away by the quality of painting over the course of the entire night, but special shout out to our four finalists. Hillary, Jordan, Frida, and Francois. These guys have just knocked it out of the park, and now we have very difficult job of choosing which one of these artists we want to send forward into the U.S. National Championship later this fall. So make sure that you get ready to vote and head over to artbattle.com/AB2631 to cast your vote for the artist that you think should earn the title of Northwest Champion. Ariel, any special thoughts from this round? Any moments that you thought were surprising?
Yeah, the round was definitely high energy. Everyone felt like they were really into it, which was really nice to see. Obviously, the stakes are high, so we got to be focused. I enjoyed the colorful portraiture. That was really beautiful. Like, everyone had their thing going. And Jordan's painting was cool. I like that it had this landscape version of the painting and a portrait version of the painting.
I agree. I thought that it was really smart and unconventional in execution. And I think that that's probably something that the crowd gravitated towards. Frida's piece, wowza.
Yeah, wow. Like, yeah, speechless. The colors were just wow. The composition was wow. I can see why she won before.
It is definitely an incredible piece with such a unique energy. I think that Jordan did a great job of capturing the energy of Jimi Hendrix as well, and especially the way that he had that personality kind of expanding across the canvas in the horizontal composition.
Yeah, that was a cool move. No one else did rotate their canvas, so it gives a whole other like visual pleasure to look at it and that angle.
And the votes are pouring in for to see who will be our Northwest champion. We're only going to have voting open for a few more minutes, so make sure that you get those votes in at artbattle.com/AB2631. I want to take this opportunity to give a special shout out to Ariel Hosseini, our co-host for this evening. Ariel, it's always such a wonderful opportunity to get your insights, especially as a championship level painter yourself.
Oh, thank you. You flatter me so much. Thank you so much, Morgan. Yeah, pleasure to be here and to experience other art battles around the world. So this is cool.
And of course, major, major shout out to all 16 artists who represented tonight at the Northwest Championship. Absolutely epic in terms of creativity and courage to step up to the easels and create in front of a large crowd in this kind of high stakes environment. But only one artist will be crowned the champion. So you guys have got to stay tuned for our winner announcement and make sure that you get those votes in.
Thank you. Thank you.
most attractive acquaintances I've ever met. You're the winner. Let's say that again. Just give a moment to the people in the gallery so they know I'm about to announce the winner. Finals 2020. What year is it? Whatever this year is, season. It went over 2023, 2024. I did forget one thank you while I was at it, which is, I mentioned Holly Moxie briefly, Bottle Bodega, but also Bottle Bodega, as well as Rogue Ales and Jaja PBX made it possible for us to expand to Portland, so great appreciation to them. All the others, so many sponsors, there's so many friends and family. Let's make something great happen. Okay. The winner. Our representative to Masters. He didn't tell you what the win other than glory. We also have an amazing trophy. We have a Jack Daniel's swag bag. I'm not sure what swag is, but it's in this bag. And $200 cash. Enough delay. We have four amazing artists. We have 60 amazing artists. Narrowed down to four. They were all nuts. Like, I got a lot of this. Those things are nuts. I hope you realize that's crazy. But our winner, as selected by you all. Where are you at, Frida Haas? Not one, but two in a row.
A huge, huge congratulations to the winner of the Northwest Art Battle Championships, Frida Haas. Frida was the winner last year, and she returned as the defending champion and once again took the title. Huge congratulations to Frida. Well-earned, well-deserved, two absolutely incredible pieces. And a huge congratulations go out to all 16 artists who painted with us tonight representing Seattle, Portland, and Tacoma. And of course, shout out to our team on the ground. Dave and Susanna, who put on such an epic show and host a really wonderful, growing Art Battle community out there. Much, much appreciated to those guys. And thank you so much to everyone who joined us on the stream tonight and watched and cheered these artists on. Thanks so much, everyone. I'm Morgan Booth.